So let's compare what we need for the conditional moves at what we need for full predication. So for the move instructions that are conditional, we need a separate opcode that tells us this is a conditional instruction. Usually, we have a separate opcode for each particular condition. So we need a number of new opcodes. For full predication, we use the same instructions that we use without conditions. We add condition bits. For full predication, however, we add condition bits to every instruction. So every instruction word contains some bits that tell us what is the condition for writing to the destination register. For example, the Intel Itanium instruction set has full predication, and this is what an add instruction would look like. It specifies the two source registers, the destination registers, that this is an add, and it has a field within the instruction to specify the so-called qualifying predicate, that is, where the condition for doing the write to the R1 register will be found in. The Itanium instruction has 41 bits, where the least significant 6 bits specify what the qualifying predicate is. The predicates in the Itanium are actually small 1-bit registers, so that you can do a condition check and store the result in this 1-bit register, and then really the 6 bits here tell you which of the 64-bit conditional registers are you going to use to determine whether to write to R1.